Computing the correlation coefficient. For example, is there a linear relationship between length of time studying in minutes and final exam test scores? To answer this question, 8 students are sampled. The following data was determined. Compute the correlation coefficient to determine if a relationship exists. Before we actually compute the correlation coefficient, we're going to construct a scatter plot to visually observe the relationship between length of time studying and final exam test scores. To construct the scatter plot, we must first identify the two variables. The two variables will be classified as X and Y. X will be known as the predictor variable. And Y will be known as the outcome variable. The predictor variable is used to measure the outcome variable, and predictions are typically made for the future. For this example, the two variables of interest are length of time studying in minutes and final exam test scores. Using the fact that predictions are made for the future, we can identify length of time studying as X and final exam test scores as Y. Now recall from algebra, X and Y represents an ordered pair. Thus, we can use the ordered pairs to create the scatter plot. The X variable will be measured by the X axis, which is the horizontal axis, and the Y variable will be measured by the Y axis, which is the vertical axis. So let's plot the ordered pairs. Since my X values range from 30 to 240, I am going to count by 50s on the x-axis. And going to 300 is good enough. On the y-axis, since my data ranges from 47 to 89, I'm simply going to count by 20s. So at this point, we're going to plot the ordered pairs. So my first ordered pair was 240 and 89. My second ordered pair was 180, 75. And you'll continue this process until you've plotted all of the ordered pairs. As you can see, there appears to be a positive linear relationship between length of time studying and final exam scores. So now we're going to turn our attention to computing the correlation coefficient in order to figure out exactly how strong the relationship is. So let's recall the formula for the correlation coefficient. The correlation coefficient is identified as R. And it is equal to the following. In the numerator, we have n times the sum of xy minus the sum of x times the sum of y. And in the denominator, we basically have two parts. We first have the square root of n times the sum of x squared minus the sum of x quantity squared. And in the second part of the denominator, we have the square root of n times the sum of y squared minus the sum of y quantity squared. where the sum of x is equal to the sum of the x values. The sum of y is equal to the sum of the y values. The sum of xy is equal to the sum of the product of x and y. The sum of x squared is equal to the sum of the squared x values. The sum of y squared is equal to the sum of the squared y values. And n is the number of pairs of sample data. To calculate r, first, let's recall the original data. The length of time studying in minutes was identified as x. And final exam test scores was identified as y. In this second step, we're going to create a table which includes x, y, xy, x squared, and y squared. By creating this table, we can then find the sums a lot easier. So first, we're going to document our x values. And then we're going to document the y values. Now we're going to find the xy values, and these values are found by taking x times y. So for the first value, we're going to take 240 times 89. So 240 times 89 is 21,360. Next, we're going to take 180 times 75. And once you take 180 times 75, you get 13,500. And then you'll repeat this process until you find all of the remaining products of x and y. Next, we're going to find the x squared values. And these values are found by simply squaring each x. And so for our first value, we're going to take 240 squared. So 240 squared gives us 57,600. For the next x squared, we're going to square 180. And that gives us 32,400. And again, you'll repeat this process until you find all of the squared x values. Finally, we're going to square the y values. And so we're going to take each y and literally square them. And so our first y is 89. And so if we take 89 squared, we end up with 7921. Next, if we square 75, we get 5625. And you will repeat this process until you square all of the y values. Now that we have our table created, we can finally find the sums of each column. And so first we're going to find the sum of x, and that's literally found by adding up all of the values in the x column, and that's equal to 1030. Next, we're going to find the sum of y, and again, that's found by simply adding up all of the values in the y column, and that's 555. The sum of xy, again, once you add them all up, you end up with 77,730. For the x squared column, once you add all of them up and find the sum of x squared, you end up with 167,500. And for our final column, once we sum all of the y squared values, we get 39,779. In this final step, we're going to plug the values into the formula, but first let's recall the formula. For this example, there were 8 data values, so n is 8. The sum of xy was found to be 77,730. The sum of x was 1,030. The sum of y was 555. Recall that the sum of x squared was 167,500. And then we're going to subtract out the sum of x quantity squared. So the sum of x was 1,030, and we're going to square that value. Now be careful not to confuse sum of x squared with sum of x quantity squared. Sum of x squared is basically summing the x squared values, and the sum of x quantity squared is squaring the sum of x. Sum of y squared was 39,779. And the sum of y was 555. And again, we're going to square that value. In this next step, we're going to simplify the numerator. I'm first going to take 8 times 77,730. And then I'm going to take 1,030 times 555. So I ultimately end up with 661,840 minus 571,650. In the denominator, I have two radicals, and so I'm going to simplify what's under the first radical first. So I am going to first square 1,030 and then multiply 8 times 167,500. So again, I'm just going to write this in pieces so that I don't do the math too soon and make mistakes. Under the second radical, same thing, I'm going to square 555 and then multiply 8 by 39,779. Next, we're going to subtract the values. And so in the numerator, once I subtract the two numbers, I end up with 50,190. In the denominator, under the first radical, once I subtract the two numbers, I end up with 279,100. And under the second radical, I get a value of 10,207. Next, I'm going to take the square root of 279,100. That gives me 528.299. Then I'm going to take the square root of 10,207, and that gives me 101.0297. Next, I'm going to multiply those two numbers in the denominator and I get a value of 53,373.889. And in this last step, I'm going to divide, and I get a value of 0.94. So this value of 0.94 is close to 1, so this tells us that there is a strong positive linear relationship between the length of time studying and test scores for a final exam.